Hello, curious minds. Imagine waking up on a distant planet, millions of miles from Earth, with nothing but the vast expanse of space around you. How long could you survive in the harsh conditions of our solar system's most extreme worlds? First, we're waking up on Mercury, the sun's nearest neighbor. Now, if you're imagining a sunny beach vacation, you might want to reconsider. Mercury is a world of extremes, with temperatures fluctuating wildly between the scorching day and frigid night. During the day, it's hot enough to melt lead, soaring to an unimaginable 800 degrees Fahrenheit. Come nightfall, however, the thermometer plummets to a chilling negative 290 degrees. This dramatic temperature swing is due to Mercury's lack of a significant atmosphere to regulate the heat. An atmosphere, or rather the lack thereof, poses another challenge. With virtually no air to breathe, you'd suffocate in moments. Also, without an atmosphere to protect from solar radiation and meteor impacts, you'd be exposed to the full fury of space. Lastly, Mercury's low gravity, just over a third of Earth's, might sound like fun, but it could have serious health implications. Long-term exposure could lead to muscle deterioration and bone loss. So if you ever find yourself on a trip to Mercury, be sure to pack your spacesuit and a seriously good air conditioner. Even then, without proper protection, humans wouldn't last more than a few seconds. It's clear that Mercury, while fascinating, is a far cry from a hospitable home for humans. Moving on to Venus, often called Earth's evil twin. While Venus's size and composition are similar to our home planet, the conditions there are far from hospitable. Venus is shrouded in a thick, corrosive atmosphere primarily composed of carbon dioxide, with clouds of sulfuric acid that make for a rather unpleasant environment. These toxic clouds not only block out sunlight, creating a perpetual twilight, but they also generate a runaway greenhouse effect. This effect results in the surface of Venus being hotter than any other planet in our solar system, even Mercury, which is closer to the sun. Temperatures there average around 870 degrees Fahrenheit, hot enough to melt lead. Imagine being in a pizza oven. That's essentially what it would feel like on Venus. But the temperature isn't the only obstacle. The atmospheric pressure on Venus is about 92 times greater than Earth's. That's the equivalent to being about 3,000 feet underwater on Earth. A human exposed to these conditions would be crushed instantly. The combination of this extreme heat and pressure makes Venus the most hostile planet in the solar system for human life. It's a place where our survival gear would melt, our electronics would fail, and we would be crushed and cooked simultaneously. So, on Venus, the intense heat and pressure would crush and cook us in moments. Next, we're off to Mars, the red planet. Mars, the fourth rock from the Sun, is often dubbed as Earth's sibling due to its similarities with our home planet. But don't be fooled, the conditions here are far from hospitable. Let's talk about the Martian atmosphere first. It's incredibly thin, about 100 times less dense than Earth's. This means that it has very little capacity to retain heat, making Mars a rather chilly place, with average temperatures dropping to minus 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Brr, and then there's the water, or more accurately, the lack thereof. While Mars does have ice caps at its poles, liquid water is virtually non-existent on the planet's surface. This is due to the planet's low atmospheric pressure, which prevents water from existing in its liquid form for long. But despite these harsh conditions, there are tireless efforts to make Mars habitable for humans. Scientists and space agencies around the world are exploring innovative ideas like terraforming, which involves altering the planet's environment to make it more Earth-like. This could include warming the planet up, thickening the atmosphere, and even introducing water. However, as it stands today, the reality is stark. On Mars, with the current conditions, humans could survive only a few minutes. But who knows what the future holds? As we continue to push the boundaries of our knowledge and technology, the dream of turning Mars into our second home remains alive. Now, let's journey to Jupiter, the gas giant. Jupiter is the behemoth of our solar system, a world of extremes where the normal rules of earthly existence are tossed aside like a feather in a hurricane. Firstly, we must address the elephant in the room. Jupiter has no solid surface. The planet is essentially a massive ball of swirling gases and liquids, with clouds made of ammonia crystals and possibly even water. If you were to try to stand on Jupiter, you'd simply sink down, deeper and deeper, until the pressure and heat became too much to bear. Adding to this, Jupiter's gravity is a staggering 2.5 times that of Earth's. Just imagine, every step would feel like lifting an elephant. Your body would be under constant, overwhelming pressure, making movement next to impossible. But it's not just the gravity and lack of solid ground that would make our stay on Jupiter brief. The planet is also bathed in deadly radiation, far more intense than anything we experience on Earth. This radiation is so powerful, it could strip away a spacecraft's electronics in moments, let alone what it could do to a human body. In essence, a visit to Jupiter would be a one-way trip to a world where the very air is a sea of liquid and gas, where you'd feel unimaginably heavy and where the air itself is filled with deathly radiation. In Jupiter, we would be crushed, frozen, and irradiated in a matter of seconds. Next stop, Saturn, the ringed planet. Imagine, if you will, the sixth planet from the Sun, a gas giant known for its stunning rings made of ice and rock. But don't let its beauty fool you. Saturn is a world of extremes, a place where human survival would be an impossibility. Firstly, the temperature. Saturn is incredibly cold, with an average temperature of negative 275 degrees Fahrenheit. That's colder than the coldest temperature ever recorded on Earth. In such extreme cold, a human would freeze instantly. Secondly, the winds. Saturn's winds are some of the fastest in the solar system, reaching up to 1,000 miles per hour near the equator. That's over 4 times faster than the strongest winds ever recorded on Earth. In such high winds, a human would be blown away in an instant. Lastly, the surface, or rather the lack thereof. Saturn is a gas giant, which means it doesn't have a solid surface for us to stand on. If you were to attempt to walk on Saturn, you would simply fall into the planet, sinking into its dense atmosphere until the pressure and temperature became too much to bear. So while Saturn may be a breathtaking sight to behold from afar, it's certainly no place for a human. On Saturn, we'd be frozen and blown away in seconds. Now we're off to Uranus and Neptune, the ice giants of our solar system. Uranus, the seventh planet from the Sun, and Neptune the eighth, are often referred to as the ice giants. Not because they're made of ice, but because a significant portion of their mass is comprised of icy materials like water, ammonia, and methane. These are the coldest planets in our solar system, with average temperatures plummeting to minus 320 degrees Fahrenheit on Uranus, and a bone-chilling minus 355 degrees on Neptune. Now, imagine trying to survive in such extreme cold. It would be like being dropped into the middle of Antarctica in the dead of winter, but hundreds of times colder. The human body simply isn't equipped to handle such frigid conditions. In mere moments, every cell in your body would freeze solid. But the cold isn't the only challenge we'd face on these ice giants. Uranus and Neptune are also home to some of the most extreme weather in the solar system. Neptune boasts the fastest winds, reaching speeds of over 1,300 miles per hour. That's faster than the speed of sound. Uranus, while not quite as windy, still has gusts that can reach up to 560 miles per hour. No structure built by humans could withstand such powerful winds. Then there's the pressure. As you descend through the clouds of these planets, the pressure increases dramatically. By the time you reach the core, the pressure is millions of times greater than what we experience here on Earth. It's the kind of pressure that crushes submarines and would instantly flatten anything or anyone unprepared for it. So, as fascinating as these ice giants are, they're not exactly prime real estate for human habitation. The extreme cold, high winds, and crushing pressure make survival impossible. On Uranus and Neptune, we'd be frozen and crushed in moments. Finally, we're at the edge of the solar system on Pluto. This dwarf planet, once considered the ninth member of the solar system, holds its own unique challenges for human survival. Let's start with the extreme cold. Pluto is so far from the Sun that it receives very little light and heat. Because of this, its surface temperature can drop to less than 400 degrees below zero Fahrenheit. Yes, you heard that right. 400 degrees below zero. This intense cold would instantly freeze any exposed skin and make it impossible for humans to survive without highly specialized equipment. Next, we have to consider Pluto's thin atmosphere. It's so thin, in fact, that it's practically non-existent. This lack of atmosphere means there's no breathable air, and the low pressure would cause bodily fluids to boil at body temperature. And finally, let's discuss the distance from the Sun. Traveling to Pluto would take years, even traveling at the speed of light. This long journey would pose serious challenges to our mental and physical health, not to mention the vast amounts of resources needed for such a trip. So, in a nutshell, Pluto is a fascinating world, but it's not exactly hospitable to humans. The extreme cold, the lack of a breathable atmosphere, and the great distance from the Sun all combine to make survival here a near impossibility. On Pluto, we'd be frozen solid in moments. As we wrap up our journey through the solar system, it's clear that the challenges of human survival beyond Earth are immense. Yet, as we push the boundaries of space exploration and technology, the dream of living among the stars remains alive. What are your thoughts on humanity's future in space? Share below. Thanks for joining us on this cosmic adventure. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more captivating content exploring the mysteries of the universe. Keep looking up!